Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video we are going to see love in the general for the sign of Capricorn for the month of October. So watch this video if you're a Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, or if you're dealing with one. Keep in mind these are general readings, so it may or may not resonate. If it do not resonate, do not try to deliberately fit in. Check in any other placement. If you want to have a personal reading, link is in the description. If you want to follow my Instagram, the link is in the description. Now let's see messages for Capricorns for the month of October 2021. Messages for Capricorn. Alright, what is the present energy for Capricorn, please? Nine of Wands. start with a bang. Yeah, exactly, of course. Like, I see you were, right off the bat, I see you were dealing with someone who was a fuckboy, fuckgirl centric situation. Somebody took advantage of you, somebody might have used you for sex. Now, that could be a very strong term, but I can just say, if not for sex, then this person was only there for fun and games. Like, this person definitely brought in a lot of excitement into your life, but when you asked about commitment, they ghosted you. So somebody has ghosted you after having fun together or having good times together. So you definitely feel cheated and betrayed. Some of you feel that this person has used you for sex. Like, that's definitely the energy that you are feeling. Some of you, it was a fire sign or a Scorpio that you were dealing with. So what is Capricorn's present energy now? Some of you, like, yeah, five of swords, of course. Like, what else will you feel after being cheated, right? So some of you, Capricorn, I keep on getting that you feel cheated, you feel betrayed. You are very bitter about this situation. You feel that somebody has taken advantage of your kindness, of your caring nature. You know, Capricorn people are really caring, and they are someone who work really, really hard, not only in work, but in every area of their life. You know, they kind of take responsibilities of everything around them, and then they just want to make things better for everybody around them. So I see that your kindness was taken advantage of, your caring nature was taken advantage of, and now you're feeling very bitter about the situation. You are like, why did I ignore the red flag when I was seeing in this person? Why did I let them do this? Why did I let them take advantage of me? So you're feeling kind of regretful about the situation. Some of you also want to take revenge. You just want to, like, go and punch this person in the face, maybe. I don't know. Yeah, Ace of Wands. You are desperately looking for a new start in your own life. You're like, fuck this shit, fuck this person. Let me just go and focus on my own self, my own energy. You feel very drained and very betrayed, of course, and you feel very drained. Some of you, you just want to start your life all over again. You feel that this situation has ended, and it has ended for good. And now you just want to move ahead in life and do you. So yeah, somebody kind of played games with you. I see somebody has played games with you, manipulated you recently. And all of this is bothering you a lot, because you're like, how the fuck did this person play me? I am so intelligent. So you're not able to kind of accept the fact that somebody did this to you. Let's see this person's feelings towards you, Capricorn. Queen of Swords. Ooh, this person knows that you know about their games. Some of you, I also feel that this person thought that you would never get to know, like, whatever they were doing. They thought that they were very smart and Capricorn is never going to get to know, but you got to know, and now this person know that you know. Is it making sense? Like, this person knows that you're very upset with them and you are going to cut them out of your life if they try to come back to you. So this person knows that you are very bitter right now and you're very agitated at them as well. However, this person would try to give a shot with you. Some of you, this person left you when you were pregnant, or they are pregnant, I don't know. Something about pregnancy is also very prominent here. With the Empress card again, this person's feelings towards you, they know that you are very bitter, but they also know that you are very caring and very kind. So they are hoping that if they come back to you, maybe one more time, you will show your kindness to this person. You know, they are that level of a fool that they think that they can come back to you and you are going to accept them. But maybe some of you are going to accept them because you have their child, or your child is with them. I don't know. So yeah, somebody just ghosted you very mercilessly, and now this person is anticipating if you will accept them or not. Like, that's some level of audacity that they have. Six of Swords. However, you feel that you have seen whatever you had to, and now you're ready to move on from the situation. You think that you have already taken more than you deserved. Like, this person was playing games with you over and over again, and you were still putting up with their BS, and now you feel you can't do it anymore and you need to walk away from the situation. So that's your energy. You feel you can't take it anymore. You're just trying to divert this attention to your own self, and you're just trying to build your own self. You're trying to stand up for your own self. I see you have become very strong in the process. I'm not saying that you were weak earlier, but now this situation has forced you to become strong. So you don't have any other option rather than to stand for your own self, for your own self-respect. So that is what is happening right now in your life. And all of this has happened after a very sudden breakup or sudden revelation of some sort. I think something about this person came to the light which you never really anticipated, and now you're like, holy crap, this person was doing this behind my back? Oh my god. Some of it, the situation became very chaotic because maybe more than one person was involved. You know, tower card can be you catching somebody red-handed, or you just got to know something about them very unexpectedly, and now you're like, this connection cannot be worked upon. You feel that it has shattered, all right? So you don't really trust this person or this situation anymore. You feel this connection is not for you and you just want to walk away. What else? So what's the future energy of a Capricorn? Yeah, Ace of Swords. Exactly. See, Ace of Swords and Ace of Wands definitely shows that you are trying to go on a new journey, on a new path. You want to explore what else is possible for you. You're trying to find your passion and happiness elsewhere. You feel that this person cannot give you what you want. So rather than waiting for this person to change, you are hoping to just find your passion, lost passion and lost happiness somewhere else. So I see a very determined towards a new change. Ten of Cups. You're trying to find your happiness, your balance. Some of you, you're trying to hope for a marriage. So some of you, you feel that you're just kind of done with the fuckboy, fuckgirl scenarios, and now universe should give you a marriage potential kind of a partner. So you're looking for marriage. You're looking for a connection that can lead to marriage. So your focus is a lot to find somebody stable. Some of you, your focus is also your family, because 10 of Cups can be family. So it's like you are just done with people, like the lovers and all of that, and you're trying to redirect your energy towards your family. Like, you just want to spend some time with your family. You just want to take care of your family. You don't want to date with anybody for now, and you just want to take a break. Some of you, I also feel that you might be investing in property. So you might be buying a house. You might be renting a house. I don't know. Something about home and family is very prominent here. Yeah, Eight of Pentacles and Six of Wands. You are trying to focus on a new project. Some of you, you're trying to take new projects in your workspace so that you can be busy, or you're learning a new skill. You're trying to keep yourself very busy. You're trying to redirect your energy towards your career so that you can advance in your career, and so that you don't think about all of this drama that happened in your life. So you're trying to shift your focus for time being. And you've become very strong. I keep on getting that you've become very strong with the Eight of Pentacles and Six of Wands. Again, you're in a very victorious energy. Though you have gone through something of death kind of a situation, but you feel that all of this actually made you very strong. So yeah. So what is the advice for Capricorn moving forward? High Priestess. Rely on your intuition, Capricorn. Your intuition is trying to tell you something, but you are like very closed off to your own intuition. You're not able to trust anything right now. These days, you feel that nothing is making sense. So you're just shutting yourself, your own self. You're shutting your own mind, all right? So stop doing that. If you're getting an intuitive nudge about something or someone, just try to pay attention. And I also feel that you're just becoming very closed off to love. You know, High Priestess is not somebody who's going to go and actively pursue somebody. So if you're single and you're looking for love, but your approach is very cold and very distant, and that is going to hinder your prospects for relationship. So try to put yourself out. Your intuition is also guiding you regarding a love opportunity. So some of you, you will be having a love options. Two equally good people will be arriving into your life, but right now you're just very closed off, so you might miss onto a very good opportunity in love. So try to focus on that. All right, I see that definitely there was a betrayal. It led to a lot of disappointment. Maybe you guys also had disagreements, fights, bad mouthing or whatever. But past is past, all right? Don't bring that conflict and drama in your present and future. Focus on your happiness. Focus on what you can build, because I see good opportunities coming in, recognition coming in. But you're just going to close off to it, and then later on you might regret. So just try to see that you do not let your internal conflict mess up the situation for you, all right? Six of Cups. And there's this also, you know, we are already in Mercury retrograde, so I feel that this past person who created so much drama in your life might also try to show up, because Six of Cups is my card of reconciliation. So there could be someone from the past who wants to have your attention, but then you also have someone else who's like really good. So you will be torn apart between two situations where you will have to make a decision as to you want the past person or the new person, all right? And maybe this is what your intuition is guiding you. So your intuition is going to help you in this situation where you will have to make a decision. So make sure that you listen to your intuition, all right? So yeah, love is definitely showing up in your life, though you are trying to take a step back from the situation to contemplate and to just see what happens. But love is showing up in your life. Two of Pentacles and Six of Cups definitely shows to me that you have more than one option. Seven of Swords. Somebody is trying to ignore their feelings. This could be you, this could be a person. Like, somebody has feelings with the Six of Cups, but how are they behaving? They are behaving like a Seven of Swords. They are showing to the other person that they don't have any feelings. This could be a person as well. So even though when this person tries to come back to you, they would want to be with you, but how are they going to behave? They are going to behave in a way like, yeah, I am good, Capricorn, how are you? I was not missing you, I just thought I will check upon you. Why do you check upon somebody? That's when you miss somebody, right? So yeah, like, this person might be a little contradicting when they come back to you. And I see now, because of their wishy-washy ways, you're just going to turn your back to all this drama. You feel this person is just a drama bitch and you can't put up with their BS. So some of you are kind of fed up with this person and their drama, and you're hoping for a better situation, a better person, or a better opportunity. And meanwhile, you're trying to redirect your focus to your money and work. Your money and work seems to be a major priority these days. You're just trying to be, yeah, see, again, Knight of Pentacles. You're trying to be independent, you're trying to be self-sufficient, you're trying to have your own coins. Some of you might be moving, so maybe a job location change, moving places, moving house, I don't know. Something about moving is also very significant here. And love is showing in your life. See, again, the King of Cups. And we already had King of Pentacles also while shuffling, so yeah. Two different people, two different energies are showing up in your life. Who do you decide is your choice. Some of you feel very betrayed in the situation because, you know, you kept showing up with this past person, but they never really appreciated. And now when you're trying to move on, this person wants to come back in your life. They are still going to come back with their wishy-washy ways. So you're kind of fed up. You're like, I am done with your nonsense. And they want your mercy. They want that for one last time you should accept them. So this person has some level of audacity, is what I see. Three of Swords. Yeah, you feel you cannot give this person a chance because they have been playing games with you in the past and they just came and left as and when they pleased. And now you feel there's no point. You're trying to focus on a new connection or maybe a new opportunity. And some of you also feel that I want commitment and this past person cannot give me commitment. All they give me is depression. All they give me is heartache. So you're like, no boy, bye boy, or bye girl. You're trying to focus that energy elsewhere. I keep on seeing that you're first of all focusing a lot on your money, your stability, and your focus is marriage. Anything below that, you don't even want to talk about it. You want to talk about somebody who is in for marriage. And if this person cannot give you commitment, you're out. Ten of Swords. See, this past person, you feel it's a done and dusted story. You have a very cold approach when it comes to your past. And to an extent, you have the same approach to a new person as well. So right now, your mind is very foggy. You don't know which person to choose, which direction to take, who to trust, who not. And the answer is that your intuition is guiding you. Try to focus on your intuition. Some of you maybe try journaling, expressive writing. That's going to give you clarity what to do. It's good to focus on yourself, but don't detach yourself from everything and everyone, right? Okay, any other final outcome for Capricorn? Five of Wands. And just be careful that you don't get into unnecessary drama. I somehow feel that, you know, there could be someone around you who will try to create unnecessary drama, unnecessary conflict. They will try to include a lot of people in the situation and they will try to unnecessarily pull you down, bog you down. Don't be part of the crowd where people are dramatic, all right? Just leave. Protect your peace of mind. So I see that. But yeah, I see two opportunities in love. One new person, one old person, or both old people, I don't know. Old person coming back, so you can decide what you want. Attraction. You attract romantic love by enjoying this moment fully. So you don't even know, but yeah, there are two people who are interested in you. And they might be interested in you because you're doing really well in your life these days. You're enjoying your life. But you are in the retreat mode, definitely. That's why you're not able to see that people are interested, but people are interested. Some of you feel it's an unrequited love. You feel you don't want anybody, but people want your time. So you can decide if you want to give somebody a chance or not. It's your call. All right, give me a message for Capricorn, please. Meditate and contemplate. See, again, some of you feel very confused these days. You're like, what to do, what not? I'm not sure. What should I do? And all of that. Your message is going to come from meditation and contemplation, and it's the same freaking message. High Priestess is Pisces, by the way, and here again we have New Moon in Pisces. So yeah, meditation, contemplation, journaling could be a way for you to get clarity, so try that, alright? Confidence is your key. Wow, that's nice. Some of you work on your self-confidence as well. You're just trying to escape the situation. You're trying to hide from the world and you're just trying to distance yourself. That's not the solution, all right? Come out of your zone. Try to interact with people as well. Not the drama people, but good people. Try to put yourself out. Try to take risks. Try to take things head on. And I see life is going to turn for better, all right? So that was a very beautiful, empowering reading, in fact. And I hope this helps and resonate. If it does, make sure you subscribe, like, share, comment. I will see you very soon in the next video. Till then, you guys, take care. Stay safe. Bye.